James Cummings has had a remarkable year, especially with a two-year-old. He's got five in the race.
It's just too difficult. I think the whole field is too difficult to sell even one. And it's all about what this sliver win is about to do. And you know what? I hope it's one of ours because they've had great preps, but the reality is it's the hardest two-year-old race in the country to win, and I would be honoured to be even in the mix.
In terms of the track, where do you want them coming?
Oh, look, one thing I said to the guys, you know, we've trained them as individuals, and it's got us here so far, so we'll be riding them as individuals today, and each jockey will be taking his horse where he feels it gives his horse the best chance.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Riders, as any, but you expect the good riders. You look at Bowman, McDonald, Berry, Lane. They're a good lot, and McAvoy, eh?
I tell this story against James. When he got offered the job of Godolphin, we were chatting about other horses at the time, and he said, "Do you think I should take it?" I said, "I think it's a good idea."
And a good idea has turned out to be not only for him, but for Sheikh Mohammed as well.
It has indeed.
It's been quite a remarkable couple of years for this young star of Australian racing with arguably the most influential owner in the sport. So we get to that big, big moment when these 16 two-year-olds are going to be placed in the gates.
I think there's going to be high pressure in this, Bruce. And you've got horses like Time to Rain and Free of Debt. They've all drawn outside barriers. They have no choice. Even Dubious is drawn.
They're going to go forward.
They have to go forward, which is going to mean... And then you've got horses like Cosmic Force. It doesn't want to be too far away from the inside barrier. And Microphones. So they're going to make those horses work.
I agree with you. I think it's going to be very high pressure. The first 400 metres of this race is going to tell a big story. They get the speed high enough, a horse like Yes 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 can tack onto the bunch and win. If they slacken off the speed after the first 400 metres, then it's going to make it really tough for the back markers.
See Tenley closing on the toe too with Cosmic Force. I mean, basically 10 cents between them. Microphone next, and then right with Microphone, Yes Yes Yes. So they're the four that have sort of extricated themselves from the other dozen in the race. Fillies dominate in terms of numbers. The last two runnings, six fillies have run 1, 2, 3. So for the last 2 years, a colt has not been able to get into the frame. Can they today? They're outnumbered. There's only six of them, and there are 10 fillies. It's the big one in Sydney at Rosehill Gardens. It's the 2019 Monchin Golden Slipper. Last to go up into the gates. So the rule locked in now. The Golden Slipper of 2019. And we're ready for a start. Racing now. And a great start. Loving Gabby Jump, particularly well with Free of Debt, Kiamichi up wide. Ventura, Valaria, and Anahita mustering quickly, followed then by Dubious going forward, then Cosmic Force, Time to Rain. Microphone back on the inside, followed by Catch Me. They're followed then by Lyre Court, a bit deep on the outside of Pin Sec. Well back then is Tenley in the red cap on the inside of Accelerates. And Yes, Yes, Yes gives away a big start. Kiamichi takes the lead inside the 700 from Anahei, Ventura, Valares moving up on the outside. Then came Dubious, Cosmic Force, Free of Debt drops back from Loving Gabby. Microphone next on the rails. Time to Rain's hard at it, followed by Leia. Then Pin Sex, Accelerate and Catch Me. Yes, 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 and Tenley are last and second last. Kiamichi at the 350 lead. Under the pump is Anahei, followed by Ventura, Valare. Microphone's picking up on the rails. At the 200, Kiamichi, two lanes clear from Anahei. Microphone, wide out Loving Gabby. Live with a big run late, but Kiamichi's clear. They're queued up, Microphone second. It betrayed, giving chase. Kiamichi in front from Microphone and Lyre, and Kiamichi led all the way. Kiamichi beats Microphone in the slipper, and getting up for third in the white cap was Lyre, then Loving Gabby from Time to Rain, Anahita, Cosmic Force, Pin Set, Lakeham Star, Catch Me, then Yes, 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 then Jared Valare from Dubious. Tenley didn't get into it. With Accelerates and Free of Debt. Extraordinary performance. I mean, this horse was bettered yesterday. When she won last week at the Magic Night, we thought, will she back up? James Cummings said, yes, she will back up. She was really, I guess, of the five that he had, the one least likely. I've got to say, before the turn, nothing was travelling as well as her, were they?
She flew the gates from gate 17 and just went straight forward and got herself in a spot there, and from then on, she just coasted.
So Esther Jarvin all the way last year. This one bleeds all the way this year.
Instead of having a drink with Robin, I'll be...